Toward the start of the film, it is shown that science has become exceptionally. Even it can see. Us the mark of soul existence. Science can educates us everything concerning soul many eyes are. Displayed in the following scene. After centering the eyes, it is uncovered that the eyes of two people are not the same. Humans have different eyes. It implies everyone's eyes are one of a kind. Like our fingerprints, the fingerprints can't be equivalent to our eyes. The primary person of the film, a young man named Ian, is introduced. Ian is a researcher and is shown exploring creatures' eyes. His story is subsequently heard in his own voice. It was his biography that changed his life. The scene shifts quite a long time back when Ian peruses in the college.but he wasn't getting a charge out of it as he could do without this party. He was leaving. From there, Ian has come to a party tossed by his school. In the meantime, he sees a young lady. When he considers moving out, we couldn't see that young lady's face as she takes care of her face. Ian sees the young lady and pushes toward her to inquire as to for what reason would she say she is standing there? Why she didn't hit up the party? Hearing this, the young lady expresses, "Take a gander at the moon, how pretty is it?" Here, Ian investigates that young lady's eyes. They are wonderful and, Ian says, "Your eyes are lovely. Can I snap a photo of your eyes?" Hearing this, the young lady says, "Okay, why not?" Ian does likewise and snaps a photo of her eyes. Later, the young lady asks Ian to hit up the party. Then they came to the party and they were getting a charge out of it this time. Ian is working in his lab with his companion in the following scene. Meanwhile, Ian's female partner shows up and starts working with Ian. In that lab, she has come here according to routine to work with Ian. Then, Ian shows them the trial he has done on mice eyes. Ian's associate becomes dazzled by seeing it. Ian is displayed at his home while watching the image of that young lady's eyes around evening time. The young lady with the cloak he met at the party. Ian dozes while seeing her eyes. Later, Ian moves into a transport to go to his lab. He gets off the transport on the way because of some reason. Meanwhile, he sees a board in front in which there were the young lady's eyes whom he met at the party. Even he has made its image. Ian finds the young lady is a model and Ian arrives at his lab and exploration that girl. This young lady is named Sophie and she is a model. Then Ian is displayed on a train where he sees the model Sophie. She was sitting a ways off from Ian remains from his place and sits close. Sophie remembers him as she sees him, and still, at the end of the day, she didn't react. She leaves when the train stops and Ian additionally moves behind her. Moving a ways off, they begin conversing with one another while talking. Sophie tells Ian that she was brought into the world in Argentina. Then I moved to France when I was 11 years old. Hearing this, Ian likewise tells Sophie about him that I am a researcher and exploring creatures' eyes. End quote. Sophie, end quote. Let me let you know a certain something. Your eyes are the most lovely I've at any point seen. That's the reason I have caused an image of your eyes, as I to have never seen eyes like yours. An association was made between them. While talking. Later, Sophie comes to Ian's home with him, converses with one another, and has a decent time. They were meandering outside and saw a white peacock and it looked lovely. Seeing it, Sophie tells Ian that the white peacock is viewed as a spirit image in Indian culture. It signifies the presence of a spirit nearby a white peacock. Ian begins educating her regarding the logical realities. We find that they are inverse to other. They are unique. End quote. Lan end quote. Is shown residing at end quote. Sophie's inquire, house, and quote. Sophie inquire, shows her parents' image to, and quote. Lan and he becomes miserable to see her parents' image. He reviews his folks seeing the photographs, however, he leaves while residual calm. A sculpture is displayed in inquire, Sophie's home. That has a place to inquire, India inquire. Seeing it, we find inquire, Sophie, is affectionate. Of inquire, Indian inquire. Culture the following day, inquire. Lan inquire, and his partner are shown working in the lab. They were giving the eyes to the bug that had no eyes. And quat. Lan and quat. Accepts that our eyes are not God-gifted, however people have creating organs when people are born. And quat. Lan, purposes. And quat. Sophie and quat. Reaching home then he requests that she wed him. What's more. And quat. Sophie and quat. Consents to this. The following day, they move to the court to get hitched yet they find they can't get hitched today. They were getting back being discouraged as a result of it. However at that point in quat, Ian in quat, gets a call from a partner and lets him know we can give eyes to the bug on which we are testing. Ian becomes glad to hear this and he tells Sophie about it while requesting that she move with him to the lab. Ian and Sophie come to the lab and Ian makes her meet with his colleague. Later, they tell Sophie about the bug that we are investigating it and giving it eyes. Sophie ends up being irate to hear this and says he is fouling up on the grounds that it is against nature. In the event that we reproduce a human that God has made, it will be perilous for ourselves and that human too. Hearing this, Ian tells her the logical realities and causes her to see, however unexpectedly, the corrosive drops from Sophie's hand. A few drops fall at Ian, and quat, causing serious torment as his eyes start to burn. Sophie gets terrified to see this and calls Ian's colleague. She comes and places medication in Ian's eyes because of it. The impact of the corrosive eliminates. What's more. And quat. Lan gets back with and quat. Sophie and quat. They were moving home by lift yet out of nowhere, a lift wire broke. The lift quits their seeing it, and quat. Sophie and quat. Gets terrified and begins weeping. And quat. Lan, some way or another, opens the lift's entryway and arises before he takes out. And quat. Sophie and quat. From the lift it goes drawback and quat. Sophie and quat, stalled out in it and kicks the bucket there badly. And quat, Lan and quat, becomes discouraged to see it and becomes traumatized. We discover that and quat, Sophie and quat, inquired and quat, Ian and quat, not to cover her however to copy her when she died. He does likewise and covers her bones close to the congregation subsequent to copying her. Ian becomes discouraged that he begins consuming medications in light of losing Sophie. He turns into a medication junkie, and afterward one day he gets a call from one of his partners in. Says I am coming to your home and shows him the bug on which they were experimenting. Their try was effective now the bug can see yet. Ian misses Sophie while seeing the insect. He becomes miserable that he begins sobbing while at the same time embracing his colleague. Later, the time 7 years after the fact is shown, and Ian is displayed in a TV interview. He says we have changed the nature rules while giving eyes to that insect. Ian is displayed with his companion and partner during supper. Here we find Ian's partner got hitched to his friend. Now they were expecting a child and their child kid is brought into the world following a couple of days and in. Attendant sweeps his eyes. They find the eyes of the child look like a military man. None views it in a serious way and they consider there is an error in the computer. After a couple of years when the kid develops senior, Ian gets a specialist's call and says we believe should do a few tests on that boy. For this, Ian arrives at the clinic with his partner alongside the boy. They show him an image of two canines and the kid chooses a canine among them. Later, the kid is shown an image of two females and he likewise chooses one of them. The kid begins sobbing in the wake of choosing the image and here their trial ends. Later, they get back and they begin looking for the man whose eyes look like that man. Ian finds where he resides, so Ian additionally arrives at that place. He moves to the shop and gets some information about the man arriving at here. Ian finds the man passed on numerous years ago. Now, Ian moves to that man's home while taking the address. He sees the canine on the way whom he chose and furthermore sees the woman for whom the kid wept. The woman is the spouse of the military man. After this, Ian returns to his colleague. He tells her beginning and end, calls his companion at home and provides him with the image of Sophie's eyes. He asks him for an iris sweep of that picture. His companion does likewise and begins an iris output of Sophie's eyes. He finds a man's sweep was found like Sophie's eyes 3 months before. This man is from India, and his partner requests that he go to India. Ian tells his partner, Sophie used to converse with me about India. She was additionally joined to the Indian culture. Later, Ian moves to India. Reaching Delhi, he arrives where the iris sweep of that man was held. Reaching here, Ian meets a young lady who was the director there. What's more, says while showing her Sophie's eyes that similar eyes were enlisted here. The supervisor perceives the eyes and says these are of a little kid, yet I don't have the foggiest idea where that young lady is. Correct now. Hearing this, Ian says could you at any point assist me with this? The director consents to help him and asks Ian to come tomorrow. The following day, the chief comes to a spot with Ian and gets some information about that girl. They find the guardians of the young lady kicked the bucket and she has none in this world. She has no home, so none knows where is that young lady right now. Ian gets a thought and glues the image of Sophie's eyes on a billboard. Ian and the administrator are shown together in the following scene and the chief poses not many inquiries to Ian. Are you strict? Or on the other hand, do you put stock in God? Ian says I am a researcher and simply has faith in logical facts. I don't have confidence in those things. The following day, Ian is shown sitting close to the billboard. And Quat. Ian and Quat sees a young lady gazing at a bulletin and perceives her by the search in her eyes that she is the young lady for whom he is looking for. Ian goes close to her and starts talking. Later, he takes her with him and afterward he begins probing him alongside his colleague. He shows her a few pictures and the photos were connected with Sophie. The young lady offers the right responses to all questions. Later, Ian shows her an image of three young ladies and there was Sophie's image as well. The young lady picks Sophie, and it finds the young lady was Sophie in her past life. Even then, Ian doesn't trust this. Ian and the young lady move disadvantage. Yet the young lady gets frightened as the lift opens.